Yeah, so, you know, I started the Julia project with my colleagues, Jeff Bezanson, Stefan Karpinski, and Alan Edelman in 2009. And 2012, we actually announced the project publicly. The reason we created the Julia project is because before Julia, you had languages like, you know, Python, MATLAB, R. There were these dynamic languages that domain specialists, right? If you're a mathematician, if you're a statistician, if you're a data scientist, those are the languages you like to use because they're very easy to work with. They're interactive, they're dynamic. But then in order to get performance, you have to rewrite your programs in C++, Fortran, Java, whatever be your language of choice. And every program had to be essentially written twice, especially if it had to be deployed. So if you're a financial firm and you're writing an algorithmic trading, if you're developing a machine learning model, if you're developing a drug simulator for developing new drugs, if you're doing, you know, anything, right? Performance matters, and every program had to be written twice. So we started off saying, why, you know, what if there were a language that could do that could be high performance and simultaneously be highly productive to use? And before Julia, it was widely believed that this is not possible, that you can have either performance or productivity, but not both at the same time. And so it was a bit of a risky bet in order to, you know, saying that we're going to start this project and spend so many years on it. Luckily, you know, it turned out that this is not a law of nature, that performance and productivity cannot go to hand in hand. In fact, if you see the modern languages like Go and Rust, right, they are doing the same thing in different domains. And Julia has done it in the analytical or the mathematical domain. And this is why we started the project, and here we are 10 years later. It's 500,000 users using it worldwide, taught in all the best universities. Yeah, so Julia is being widely adopted, right? So all the top universities around the world are teaching it. We are also, you know, we've seen over 12 million downloads so far. I think 13 million is the latest number. The Julia paper was cited by 1,000 other researchers, by 1,000 other, you know, papers. So it really is becoming a high impact language. A lot of the growth is coming from, you know, people using it in the sciences, in engineering, and because of our package ecosystem. So Julia has 3,000 packages. So whatever task you might want to do, there, you know, you don't have to now code it from scratch in Julia. There might actually be a best-in-class package. If you're doing data science, if you're doing image processing, signal processing, statistics, you know, deep learning, robotics, all these things are actually just available in Julia. And it's because of this that, you know, all these domain specialists, experts, when they come to Julia, they're able to, you know, start using it right away. And this is what is really driving the adoption. Another main driver that we imagine in the future is going to help us a lot is differentiable programming. And that is a true differentiator for us because, you know, we are able to differentiate increasingly large classes of Julia programs and optimize, you know, over larger data sets. So in some sense, we are able to do generalized learning instead of just deep learning using Julia. And we think that, you know, this will unlock a lot more interesting use cases and further spread the language. We estimate it's about 500,000 users already. I think the main advice I always have for everyone is that go deep, right? You know, pick up a skill, pick up an area, pick up some domain, you know, whether it's mathematical, statistical, or, you know, is it, you know, if your passion is finance, if your passion is machine learning, if your passion is, you know, biology, pick an area of choice and go deep. You know, today, you know, you have amazing, you know, training materials, university courses available online. For example, if you wanted to go deep into Julia on many of these aspects, we run juliaacademy.com. You can go there, get started. Look at all the infrastructure, or sorry, you can look at all the materials that are available online, all the courses, and you can get in fairly deep, all the research stuff. But, you know, get in, join the community, go deep, become an expert, and really try to get to the forefront of a field. Whether you do it, you know, in your job, in your college, in your PhD, or, you know, wherever it is, but strive for excellence and strive to do, you know, something that nobody else is doing. And join the community, contribute, and help. And this is what Julia Computing does. I mean, we build products to make Julia easy to use, easy to deploy, easy to scale, so that when you jump in, you dive in deep into your domain and you're building, you know, best-in-class solutions, you know, we'll be there working with you, making it happen. This is how we launched, you know, this product called Pumas for life sciences today. It's the best-in-class pharma modeling and simulation tool. It's being increasingly, you know, taught to students in the United States, in India, and worldwide. So, India has huge potential. All of us always hear that said, we have a raw talent, but I think it does not convert into the top companies around the world. It does not convert into top academics. It does not convert into top research. And so while we have a lot of amazing raw material, an amazing education system at the primary, secondary, and college levels, it does not translate into higher education. It does not translate into, you know, building companies that are, you know, powering the economy, which China has been very successful at doing. I think we have a long way to catch up. And I think our goal should not just be to catch up, but be to leapfrog, to be the best at what we can do. But it is going to be a lot of hard work, a lot of effort, and there is just no easy answer. I think we need to think about our education system. We need to think about how students are going to learn cutting-edge technologies, how they're going to get mentored, how they're going to sort of get to the, you know, forefronts of a variety of different fields. And I think the future is bright, but I think all of us need to work together and make it happen. But if we continue with things as they are, and just let things run in the regular course, I think we will end up not meeting our true potential. Yeah, it's been a great conference. We're seeing sort of, I'm surprised to see people not just from the traditional analytics and machine learning things, but I met a lot of people from the space of pharma, people who are architects, people doing many different things. We interacted with some of the sponsors from NVIDIA and all. So I think it's really a good conference. It's coming together nicely. And I think it's the first time, right? So I wish you all the best in scaling it up. And hopefully making the future that we talked about possible. I think this is a good place to build a community.